Are you struggling with posing in photos and always end up with the same kind of boring looking photos all the time? I feel you, because that was me too about a year ago. And I am not a model at all, but the last year I have spent almost every day shooting photographs and posing my sister, who is not a model, and posing myself too in self-portrait. So I have developed some tips and tricks that I use all the time to make my photos look more interesting. And disclaimer, this is not a video on how to look good in photos. There are plenty of videos out there that will show you how to look good in photos. But this is how to make your posing look more interesting and more eye-catching, and how to make your photos stand out with your posing. Oh yeah! The first one is pretty simple and easy to implement, and it is to just drop your shoulders. You can see if you sit like this, it doesn't look very confident or comfortable at all. But if you're like this, your neck will be longer. And the body will draw lines that will draw the viewer's eyes to the subject, which is what we want. Try to create space between the limbs. This will just make the subject look a lot more natural, and the lines of the body will draw the viewer's eyes through the frame. Through the frame? Through the frame, yeah. Yeah. And it will look a lot more organic. If you were just like this in the frame, it doesn't look very good. Or you don't really want to look at this. But if someone is like, you know, has flow, like an organic movement, it just looks more eye-catching. Have a stiff body. I know I just said like movement and organic space between the limbs and all that stuff, but if you're doing like the complete opposite on purpose, it will look pretty cool too. And I do this pretty often actually. And just having someone standing completely like in a straight line or something like that. It will also stand out because you're not used to seeing someone being like that doll-like. It's not very human to just be very still. We like seeing your face. That's not what I'm saying. But I'm really saying this to kind of get your mind thinking in new ways. And facing away from the camera, or just like swapping your face out with something else, or holding something in front of the camera, can be quite disturbing, and that in that way also stand out. And you can really in that way use your body to tell the story instead of always relying on the face and the eyes to tell the story that you're trying to communicate. I call this the pretzel because you're kind of like doing weird stuff with your body like a pretzel. It's kind of like the other ones where you do things that you don't normally do, and that's really what I want you to do with these poses, because that's just the way that you stand out. And by like shaping your body in a weird way like a pretzel, your photo will just automatically stand more out. And doing like the pretzel pose can both be sad like this photo, or confident like this photo. So really get creative with it and see what your body can do. Your body can do so many things, okay? Facial expressions are probably the hardest thing to do, especially when you're just starting out. And awkward too, like it's so awkward doing facial expressions, especially when there's other people around. But it's just important. And especially if you're doing a close-up. So I have three tips to kind of get you in the right direction. And the first is to open your mouth just a tiny bit and squint your eyes. Like this. Very awkward, right? But I promise you, it just looks good in photos. And the third tip is just to open your eyes immensely, like a lot, and it will just look creepy and awesome, because we like creepy and creepy stands out. final little quick tip is to tilt your head a little bit. And it just makes your facial what? Because it will just make it look more organic and real and natural. And more confident too. If you want your photos to stand out, just think about what normal people don't do, like what you don't see normally. Like you don't see someone doing the pretzel in everyday life, you know? So, and then do that in your photo, because that just will make them stand out. And of course, only do it if that's what you want and if it supports the story of the photo. Photography is art, so that is what we should strive for. And my art isn't being pretty in your photos and twisting your body slightly in the right direction to make you look skinny. That's not what I'm striving for personally, and if that's what you're striving for, then go do that. I think it's awesome. And just remember that there are really no rules to this thing. You can do whatever you want, and if you want to use one of my tips every single day, do that. And if you can't use any of it, that's fine too. And if you want to use them all, do that. There are really no rules, and just get creative with it because it's so much fun. And if you want to use some of my tips, I have created a free guide that you can get in down the description that you can print out and bring with you on your shoot. And the point is really just to get your mind thinking creatively faster when you're on your shoot, and having some ideas that you can always go to. And the guide really contains my go-to poses that I use very often. Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. Here's my Instagram. And I would love to hear down in the comments below if you are actually planning on using some of these tips, and tag me over on Instagram if you're actually using them and posting the photos. I would love to see that. That would be so much fun. And remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and hit the bell if you would like to see more of my videos. Yeah, and until next time.